Hi there, and welcome to this lecture about the British Empire. My name is Marcus Henriksson, and I'm a history teacher in Sweden. Well, from the beginning of the 17th century, Britain's colonial power and world power grew. They started acquiring colonies at an even faster pace than ever before. And until the beginning of the 20th century, they would expand their empire enormously. In the 16th century, they used pirates in order to win over the Spanish Armada. One of the pirates that had a key role were this person, Sir Francis Drake. So Queen Elizabeth teamed up with the pirates and promised them half of their earnings. They could continue to be pirates, but they shouldn't target British ships. Instead, they should only target Dutch ships, Spanish ships, French ships, and so on. That way they could defeat the Spanish fleet, and that way they could also create the world's largest and greatest empire. Here you can see the British Empire in the early 1900s. How large, you might ask? Well, in the beginning of the 20th century, they controlled an area of 33 million square miles. That is about 25% of the world's surface. Here are some formerly great kingdoms and empires. The Mongol Empire, ruled by Genghis Khan. This is the second largest empire in the world's history. But yeah, we have also the Empire of Alexander the Great, the Roman Empire, the Russian Empire, and so on. So how did the British manage to get so big, so large? Well, there are certain important factors, one of which are that they were extremely dominant at sea. They controlled the finest ships in the world, the most experienced sailors, and so on. And they would, up until the beginning of the 20th century, have the world's strongest navy. Britain would become so large not only because of its ships, but what the ships did. For one, they could travel over, let's say, the Atlantic, and to take slaves and to trade them for stuff like tobacco, sugar, cocoa, silver, gold, and they would become extremely wealthy. They could also form colonies. In the Americas, they created the 13 British colonies, which would later become the United States. They would also be involved in several battles and fights with mostly the French, but also Dutch and Spanish forces all over the planet. They usually won thanks to their large and great navy. And they will colonize several islands, such as the Jamaicas, the Honduras, Barbados, and so on. And they would use slaves on plantations in order to produce stuff like sugar, tobacco, cotton, rubber, and so on. They would also colonize Canada, where they would create a huge and large whale industry. They could also use Canada to get a lot of wood if they needed timber, for example. And they would take control over Australia. It was the British prison colony. Thanks to the triangular trade, they would get so much money that they could pour it into their industries and create the Industrial Revolution. And create stuff like the spinning jenny, the steam engine, which would then became steamboats and trains. During the 18th century, Britain's army was seen by many as one of the strongest and finest in the world. So they would not just have a great navy, they would also have a great army. And with that army and fleet, they could conquer stuff like India, for example. Usually, they used the leaders of India to fight one another and then backstab them, just like the Americans had done in the United States with the Indians. The most famous traitor of them all is Jafar, which you also can see in this Disney movie, Aladdin. From India, they would bring home spices, which would make those who traded in spices extremely wealthy. And perhaps most importantly later, cotton. They would also have the world's most powerful company, the East India Company, trading in stuff like tea, cotton, spices, and so on. When Napoleon was defeated at Waterloo at the beginning of the 19th century, it was now perfectly clear to everybody that Britain was the world's greatest power. They would also conquer several African countries, where they would mine gold, silver, and precious stones. We can also here see the world's shortest war, the Anglo-Sansibar War, which lasted about 38 minutes. There were some positives with the British rule. Among other things, they brought with them new technology, such as the telegraph, electricity, trains, and so on, when those things had become available in Britain. But yeah, there were some negatives. Exploitation of the conquered areas in order to make as much and large profits as possible. Take India, for example, converted to today's money. For example, they would grab $45 billion, which is like 17 times UK's money today. So yeah, they had mines in Africa, cotton plantations in India and Iran. They would have sugar plantations in the Caribbean, tobacco plantations and so on. So yeah, the local populations were usually enslaved. Some of them even starved and died. Here are some examples. In Iran, 8 to 10 million dead. In India, 10 to 35 million. One country that Britain really wanted to conquer was China. So soon we would see a battle between the world's military superpower during this time, Great Britain. On the other side, China, the world's economic center and world power. They stood for about 60% of the world's total GDP. How did it all begin, you might ask? Well, the English people wanted tea, and China produced a lot of tea. They also produced porcelain, silk and so forth. The British people, however, were particularly fond of tea, so they would buy lots of tea during the 18th and 19th century. Here you can see the tea and coffee consumption in Great Britain. And you can see that it really spiked during the 18th and 19th century. The Chinese wanted silver as payment, and in the beginning Britain did really well, they could pay off, but eventually the silver ran out. And remember now that Britain was the world's largest superpower during this time, but still they ran out of silver. So the British plan was to start selling Indian opium to the Chinese people. So they would basically create a large drug addiction amongst the Chinese populace, which would be terrible for the Chinese, but yeah, the British would get money so that they could buy tea. But more and more Chinese people died, and the Chinese decided to try to stop this trade. It is estimated that at least 25% of the people in China were now drug addicts. So they basically banned trade in opium. But the British didn't care. They continued this trade secretly, illegally, and smuggled the opium into China. You can see on this map how they did it. The biggest smuggler of them all was William Jardin. He's also known as China's opium king. But the Chinese got pissed off because, yeah, 25% of their population was now drug addicts. So when the Chinese government decided to destroy the British opium, the British declared war on them. And then we can see the First Opium War, which lasted between the years 1839 to 1843. And the British quickly conquered all the major coastal cities and threatened Nanking, which was then the capital of China. So basically, the British Navy was so powerful that it could easily defeat the Chinese one and take control over basically the most important places in the country. China had to pay large war reparations to the British, and Hong Kong then became British up until the year 1997. And they still have British laws in Hong Kong, which pisses the people in China off. Christianity was also allowed throughout the kingdom, and free trade would prevail in the future, also in opium. So yeah, there were two major opium wars, but China lost both of them. And opium would now be manufactured by the British in China up until the year 1949, when the Communist Party and Mao Zedong took over. They would destroy the opium plantations. So we can now see how the British gained control over the world and how it policed the world with its huge and powerful navy and military. But yeah, basically they used the colonies to suck up natural resources, everything from cotton to spices to rubber to sugar, tobacco and so on. And yeah, Great Britain would gain a tremendous wealth, but on the cost of several million people's deaths. So basically up until the beginning of the 20th century, nobody could compete with the British. They were the world's superpower up until that time. Then they would be conquered, defeated, I should say, or lose the world's superpower status to United States, which still to this day hold that title. The sources I've used for this lecture and video are History of World Societies by John P. McKay, World History New Perspective by Clyde Ponting, Perspective of History by Lars Hansen and Örjan Nyström, History by Elisabeth Ivansson, Robert Sandberg and Mattias Turday, Starvation and Colonialism by Mike Davis. Here are some links. You can feel free to pause the video if you like. Here are some documentaries. The British Conquest of India Begins, What Was Britain's Role in the Slave Trade, The Old Corruption, Britain's Slave Trade Documentary, Why These Military Leaders Failed, How Europe Colonized Asia, Great Powers of the Victorian Era. But if you have any questions at all, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Otherwise, I wish you a great day. Bye.